Nowadays, we give for granted basic rights for women to vote, but not many know the fighter who led the battle to gain those rights. Brighton can be proud of one of them, Minnie Turner, whose name has recently reappeared on one of the Brighton and Hove buses, and not only there.
Today I'm dressed as Minnie Turner, who was Brighton's suffragette. A suffragette means vote for women and the women's political movement, because in her time, in the 1800s and early 1900s, women did not have the vote. Even though they worked the same as men and paid their taxes the same as men, they were classed as kind of second-class citizens. She opened a guest house, and it was a guest house for women, teachers, professional women, nurses, doctors. And during their stay with her, she became really involved in the women's political movement. She was a bit of a militant, so she really wanted to fight her cause. She would go on marches up in London. She would arrange marches in Brighton. She was a big campaigner for the women's movement, so much so that she was actually arrested 3 times, the last time for smashing a window through the House of Commons. Any suffragette that was imprisoned for 21 days was entitled after that to wear a badge of a small portcullis that was designed by Christabel Pankhurst. And they, suffragettes who were imprisoned, wore this with pride to show that they were fighting for the cause. Brighton had a big campaigning force for women in this a town. I think she would want us to remember the fight that women had. I think she would want us to remember that women were, you know, downtrodden and classed as second-class citizens and didn't have the right. And I think she would still want us to campaign and fight for equal rights for everyone. She probably now might get involved in different religions, who knows, you know, as we all know, with different things that are going on in the world. I think the world needs to campaign, and I think she would be a big party for that. Here we have Millie's badge that she was awarded by Emily Pankhurst after she'd completed her prison sentence. This was designed by Christabel Pankhurst, Emily Pankhurst's daughter, and it was given to all suffragettes who had completed a prison sentence for the cause. So eventually, in 1918, women sort of got the vote. Any woman over 30 who owned some property was allowed to vote in this country. Everybody in Brighton can be themselves and can fight for what they want. And I'm sure that Minnie Turner would be so proud of us all here now.
This is Willie Ranieri for Latest TV News.